This is the type of paint I use, which, funny enough, when you first open it, it is kind of bluish, but when it does dry, it does turn black. Now this is indoor-outdoor, so if it gets wet, it has some protection. So that's very helpful with a fish stand. It's semi-gloss black, so it's not too shiny, but not too flat. And that's the paint I like to use. Another tip, when you're not using your paint, you can cover it up with a plastic bag. That'll keep it wet from drying out from the sun or anything. It's always good to move it out of the sun too. Just wouldn't hurt. That plastic bag will keep it wet. Sometimes you gotta wait for times to dry and it'll take longer, and you wanna keep redoing the paint, so this will save it. So let's begin here. First, I gotta choose a tank from a pile. See, I got my work cut out for me today on this. And I decided to go ahead and narrate this instead of trying to do it while I was doing it, because it's pretty wet out there and just my phone and water doesn't mix. I don't have one of those waterproof phones, but anyway, you see I got a board down there. I put that down there so it keeps the dirt and the grass off the tank. I like to give these tanks a good rinse, which you can do it in a bathtub or something with these 10 gallons, but it's just a lot easier to take them outside and hose them off. And yeah, give them a good rinse, because sometimes they'll have an oily residue on them. You never know what happens between shipping and manufacturing and being in the store. If you got any oily residues on it too, the paint will separate from it. But now that I got it all rinsed off, most of the water out, just take my tank over here to another board where I keep as a dry area. Hang my towel on a tree, makes a good towel holder. And of course, dry it off on the outside and on the inside. Make sure it's nice and dry. You don't want that water mixing with your paint, cause issues. But yeah, add it to my collection there. And these tanks are all for the new rack I just showed you guys how I built. Then since I got so many tanks I'm doing today, I grabbed a bunch of cardboard, and this is the cardboard that actually came off the tanks from when I got them in the store. They'll wrap them in these long strips of cardboard, which actually works really well for setting all the tanks on and painting them. Also use these when I'm doing the spray paint method too, to cover the tank. I just tape the top over, and I'll tape the side parts over. That way the overspray doesn't get on the side and it doesn't get inside the tank. So now I got all that cardboard stretched out. Thought I'd show you guys my nice rock pile here. No, but really I was grabbing some rocks because I didn't want the wind to blow the cardboard away. Which I thought I'd really need to do this process, but I ended up taking the rocks off because the tanks held the cardboard down. But I guess I held the cardboard down for just a small time frame that I didn't have the tanks on top of it. These weren't actually all the tanks I needed to get painted, but there's only so much time in a day and I had so many other commitments that I only had so much time. And there's my little helper counting them all, making sure they all got wet handprints on them before I start painting. He's a good little dude though. But this is what it looks like. First coat's on that tank. And yeah, I simply just got a roller. That black paint I showed you guys earlier. Kind of roll it on. No real pattern. Doesn't really have to be, because it'll all kind of smooth out when it dries. But you see I kind of stopped near the edges. And I try to push some in that edge a little bit, because when you do paint them like this, so it can be easy to leave a little gap on the tops and the bottoms, just because the way the roller and the edge needs some. Yeah, smooth it out. There, yeah, there I'm pushing that paint in the edge. See how it's just getting rid of that a little bit. A lot of times I'll, if I have any thin spots or if there is some oily residue, I'll go over and paint it too. But this is what it looks like after the first coat. It's shining through the sun. We got all the tanks painted. Drying out. Doesn't look like much yet. But then we move on to the second coat here. You see how quick it's starting to darken up. That's what it looks like through the sun. Just looking through the sun really give you a good judgment on how well it's going to look in the end. And then this is the third coat. Sometimes I like to do a fourth coat, but not always necessary. And like I said, I was on a time crunch, so I just got it done. But you can't see the sun shine through, so it's all good. Thanks for watching.